Welcome to this week's edition of the Ram Roundup as we continue with the men's soccer team at the NCAA Championship. We're here with head coach Jim McElderry. Jim, can you describe what the last 10 days have kind of been like for the team and the experiences that they've had, you know, over this last 10-day span?
Yeah, it's been busy. You know, I think between travel and classes and scheduling and flights, it's been a busy couple of weeks. But, you know, we wouldn't have it any other way. It's been an exciting time for our players, you know, to be able to host a game here first and win in overtime in the fashion we did, and then, you know, travel down to UVA and play a top team down there and come away with a win on the road. It's been just an incredible time for our players, but you know, they're excited to keep playing and head down to Duke and see where it goes from there.
You played Duke early on this season, so you've seen the team before. You got film on them. What do you take away from that first game earlier? I know it was only the second game of the season. You were missing a couple players due to injuries, but you know, can you take anything away from that game into this one?
Well, I think our players certainly know that they're an excellent team. We've played them down there already. They beat us pretty handily, especially in the second half. I thought we kind of ran out of steam playing Friday, Sunday. In a tournament down there, and they've got a lot of players, a lot of quality, and they've had a great season too. It's not just the name on their shirt. You know, they've had a great season. I think at one point they were 3 in the RPI, so we know they're a quality team. I think they're excited to be into the final 16 as well, so I expect it to be a good game, and you know, we'll be prepared. Now it's just about trying to get there and you know, really kind of get our feet on the ground down in North Carolina, and then we really give it a go.
Does it help having played Virginia in that last game, another quality ACC opponent with the high level of talent that Virginia had, to go into another high level talented game against Duke?
Yeah, I think so. But I really think our conference this year has helped us. We've had a lot of teams have success this year, and we played pretty much all the top teams in our conference this year. So it's been a challenge. The last month of the season has been challenging. So and then to play St. Francis Brooklyn, who had a great season, and then play the UVA. So we expect the teams all to be really good at this point of the season. So you know, playing UVA and you know, some of the athletes they had certainly does prepare us. But you know, we've kind of moved on from that now, and Duke are a different type team. They play a different style, so we've got to manage you know, those challenges too.
Here with our player interview with senior Jannik Loebe. Jannik, what has the last 10 days been like for the team?
I mean, I think it was unbelievable, especially the home game here. The atmosphere was great, so many people coming out, then being down twice, and then at least at the end getting the win, which was crazy. It was such a nice experience, and obviously last game was a little different. We were sitting in a little bit, but we fought our way through and luckily got the win at the end, and we are super happy about it and looking forward for Duke on Saturday.
The Virginia game, obviously getting on the road, hostile environment, and you guys just wait it out and you wait for that one opportunity. You get the shot, the guy makes a save, and you get the rebound right back in for the Ohlendorf goal. You know, what did it mean to have that goal happen at that point in the game, you know, 83rd minute, you know, crunch time late in the game, you know, really get your guys, you know, going for the last 7 minutes?
I mean, for us it was great, especially because it was late in the game, because the other team got nervous, obviously, just 7 minutes left. And for us it was great because we knew we just have to sit in for another 7 minutes and we get that win. But overall, I think our game going up front wasn't even too good that game, but we knew we got spaces and we just have to wait for that one chance and that one good play which came, and we're happy that we got it.
This season, the team's really been a second half and beyond team. You guys have scored 30 goals overall. 22 have been in the second half or later into overtime and stuff. Are there adjustments being made at halftime, or is it just that's when the magic happens, that the second half is when you guys come through?
I think that's our strength of the team, because we can kind of adjust to the other teams, and in halftime we always see what the other team is doing well and what not, and where we might break through. So we always adjust in halftime and doing better in the second half. And I think also fitness wise and we have a lot of possession, the other team's getting tired at the end of the game and we're still in shape, so we always get that spaces and then score at the end.
You go on to play Duke in the round of 16. It's a team you've seen before. What can you take away from that previous experience playing Duke? You know their players and what to expect. How does that help going into this game?
I mean, it helps a lot because, yeah, like you just said, we know what we have to expect. On the other hand, we also lost that game and we had a really bad game. Our performance wasn't good, so we want to make that up and obviously just want to win to go to the next round. So we're all striving for this and yeah, we're pumped to play.
Well, thanks so much, Jannik, and best of luck on Saturday.
All right, thank you.
That'll do it for this week's edition of the Fordham Ram Roundup. Fordham men's soccer in the round of 16 against number 6 seed Duke on Saturday, November the 25th, 6 o'clock start down at Duke. The game will be streamed live on ESPN3.com and the Watch ESPN app as a part of the ACC Network Extra. Again, you can always follow online, live stats, as well as on Twitter at Fordham Soccer, as always. For the Fordham Ram Roundup, I'm Scott Kwiatkowski, and we'll see you next time.